All right, everybody, it's Ross the Fig Boss. It's the end of the day. We're almost getting dark out. I've been working hard all day, bare rooting some trees for you guys. We're selling quite a few as we do almost every fall around November. We sell a lot of these bare rooted trees. I take them up out of their pot, remove all the soil, wrap the roots in wet newspaper and then a plastic bag, and then I ship them off to you guys at a much larger size. At a very cheap rate in terms of shipping. What I wanted to do was review this particular fruit here for you guys because I never got a chance to review it this year. It's quite late. It's a very, very good fig. I've had a few so far, but some of them I've picked them a little bit too early and I was not aware of, I think, exactly when this fruit needs to be picked. As every new variety you guys attain, it's the same story. You have to learn over time, after picking a few of the figs, how long to actually let the fig ripen on the tree. And it still may not even be perfect, but I am seeing a little bit of honey coming out of the eye, which is a very, very good sign. This fig here is called Nuestra Senyora del Carmen, I believe. This is a fig that is a favorite of a friend of mine named Karla. She also sells fig cuttings and whatnot at Garden Crochet, if anyone has ever heard of her. She's a very good seller and a very good fig grower. She's one of the few people I actually trust their opinions. And so this is a fig that she, as I said, is really recommending as one of the best. And she lives in Southern California, so this obviously would be a great choice for people in Southern California that live where she lives. But I figured, why not trial it here, because Karla really knows what she's talking about. Here it is, actually, and that looks pretty darn good. I think it still needs more time. You can see there's a lot of honey and nectar pooling at the void, and there's some at the eye by my thumb. It's a pretty fig, and some people might think this is kind of similar to Black Madeira, but I guarantee you it's not. I think it's going to have, though, a similar flavor profile to the Black Madeira, based on the few figs that I've tasted so far. And that's a very good thing. You know, it is a very complex fig. Hopefully you guys can see me. It's very sweet. Overall, it should be a very highly flavored fig if you're going to compare it to Black Madeira. I mean, that's just a given. And I think that's really what Karla loves about this fruit, is that it's really all about the flavor for her, but I could be mistaken. I don't want to speak for her. So if you're interested, you want to know more about this fig, I would suggest messaging her on her website, on FigBid, or you can message her on Facebook. She has a Facebook page. It's Garden Crochet. So far, I can't really observe too much about the fruit before we just bite into this. I haven't really observed too much about the tree. This is still quite young. I have one in the ground. This one here is in a 5-gallon size pot. It's still not even fully rooted out in that pot. This area of the yard, unfortunately, or this area of the patio, is a bit shaded. It is what it is. I imagine the skin will probably get a lot darker in a higher light environment. I do know that it's quite late. It definitely seems a bit late. It definitely seems to not really do well in colder conditions. So as it's been very cold, as I've been ripening this fruit the first couple times, it doesn't seem to really put up with that very well. And you know what? A lot of varieties don't. It's pretty much the majority of them don't. But there are some that I've noticed at this time of the year, they keep pumping them out. They keep going strong. Even Calderona, which is literally the pot right behind it, really finished strong this year. You know, right now, although at the time of filming, this is after my frost already. So the leaves look pretty shot on some of these trees, and especially this one. So I imagine the frost maybe has helped ripen this. Regardless, I just think, so far, it's just probably too late for this climate, and it needs a greenhouse. So if you live further up north, highly would suggest you get a greenhouse head start for this tree. and then maybe we can start to observe more things about it, make more judgments. I haven't noticed too much splitting or rain problems with it, so that's a good sign, as Black Madeira and Italian 258 typically do. And that's really what we're trying to do, is replace Black Madeira and Italian 258 with this fig here, Nuestra Senyora del Carmen. At least that's one of the candidates. So let's try it now. Oh, wow. Very good flavor. The skin is very tough. And it's not, I don't think that's normal. I don't remember in the other ones I had having that problem, but very flavorful pulp. It could have something to do with the frost. It could have something to do with how cold it is, and that's why the skin is the way it is. But the pulp is very, very good. Yeah, I mean, it's right up there with, you know, some of the Black Madeira figs I've had, Italian 258s I've had. I don't really know just yet, so this video is very preliminary. I don't know just yet how much of a difference, or if it is going to taste better here than those other figs I mentioned. So far, I do prefer Calderona, just what I've seen on these young trees I have. I'm still waiting for Colonel Littman's to really give me a good fig from that tree to see if that one's going to maybe edge out the others. But at least so far, it's a very, very good piece of fruit. Obviously, Karla knows what she's doing. I mean, of course, you'll know. Just by tasting it, you'll know. So I want to thank you guys here for watching this one. Again, if you're interested, check out Karla's page, Garden Crochet. I think it's even gardencrochet.com. And we will see everybody soon. Talk to you guys later. Thanks. Hit that subscribe button.